tries a jab. Perhaps he'll make Ponce de Leon look bad at times, but he's got the big equalizer, Joe.
He does indeed, and he had it this past July in what many are saying was the knockout of the year. Can he do it again? Will Ponce de Leon come out firing? Will Al Seager be the moving target and frustrate his opponent and pull the upset? Let's set the scene. The tail of the tape, Rich.
All right, we'll take a look at how these two square off against each other here tonight. Ponce de Leon and Al Seager. If we can get those numbers up for us.
Well, we know one thing for sure. Al Seager's the taller guy.
He sure is, and he has the advantages, and there you see it fairly dramatically. And that will all play into the styles again, once again here tonight. Look at that difference in height, 5'8 to 5'5. Look at that difference in reach, 6 inches in reach. And Seager plans to use every inch of that, Joe, to make it count.
He will need to. Outside versus inside. Seager versus De Leon.
Unified rules are in effect here for this world championship fight. There is no 3-knockdown rule nor standing 8-count. Only the referee can stop the fight. The fighters can't be saved by the bell in any round, and of course the accidental foul rule at the end of 4 rounds. We go to the cards.
Seager, make no mistake about it, a substantial underdog in this title fight. He has the style to pull it off, but does he have the overall experience to do it? He went to a Savannah, Georgia boxing gym at age 10, the only gym in town. He's grown into a smart, capable boxer. Said that all the pressure is on De Leon, that everyone expects him to come up short.
And of course, with all those fights that you're talking about that he had in Savannah, he always had the crowd backing. He will not have that tonight. And what he'll try to do is emulate Manuel Garnica to get the fighters to turn against, or get the fans to turn against the favorite of the crowd.
What he's hoping is that the judges won't mirror that split decision. There are those in the boxing biz who dismiss Daniel Ponce de Leon as a raw, wild swinging puncher. Ponce de Leon says his skill is improving. Now, the original Ponce de Leon searched for the fountain of youth. This one searching for the river of respect. Respect that has eluded him, even though he has already acquired a title. And for that to happen, Ponce de Leon needs to show the ability to adapt and to deal with a tall and slick boxer. He wasn't able to do that in his lone career loss against Celestino Caballero. But the good news is the southpaw slugger has big opportunities right in front of him for his career and trying to gain respect starting tonight. For the official introductions, here's Lupe Contreras.
Hey guys,
from the Don Haskins Center in El Paso, Texas, we present to you an evening of Mexican glory being brought to you by Oscar de la Hoya's Golden Boy Promotions, in association with Don Chargan Productions, Southwest Airlines, the new Tampico Energy Drink with its powerful citrus taste. Tampico Energy Drink es el más bravo. And HBO Pay-Per-View. This is the main event of the evening. 12 rounds of boxing for the WBO Junior Featherweight and IBA Super Bantamweight Championships of the World. WBO Supervisor, Rafael Lopez Santos. Supervising for the IBA, Norm Longton. The judges are Ruben Carrion, Levi Martinez, and Gail Van Ooy. The referee, Lawrence Cole. And now, ladies and gentlemen, with two world titles on the line, two champions representing the USA and Mexico, the moment has come to find out who is El Más Macho. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, he steps into the ring wearing dark blue trimmed in light blue, weighing in at 122 pounds. His professional record, 27 victories with one lone defeat, and 21 of his victories coming by way of knockout. The IBA Super Bantamweight Champion of the World, from Savannah, Georgia, Al Quiet Storm Seager. Across the ring in the red corner, he steps in wearing black trunks trimmed in gold and weighing in at an identical 122 pounds. As an amateur, he proudly represented his homeland of Mexico in the 2000 Olympics. And as a pro, he maintains a record consisting of 29 victories with one defeat, and 27 of his victories coming by way of knockout. The WBO Junior Featherweight Champion of the World, de Cuauhtémoc, Chihuahua, Mexico, Daniel Ponce de León.
Al, Daniel. Let's go, Daniel.
I can never quite figure out why a guy like De León needs 10 people in his corner prior to the introduction.
Touch
him up. Al Seager had only two in the old style in his corner.
It has been a highly entertaining pay-per-view card here in El Paso. Jerry Penaloso with the knockout win.
Come on, Jojo.
The prospect Antonio Escalante with the knockout win. The controversial but entertaining fight between Lescano and Garnica. And now this tremendously interesting stylistic matchup between the brawler and the boxer.
One thing about Al Seager that we should touch on too, if he gets a chance, he's not a pity pat light puncher. He has 21 KOs in his 27 victories, so he's got some punch.
Showed a pretty good right hand there to open this thing up. He thought that that would be one of the big keys to this fight, the fact that they don't respect his punch, but you gotta respect that left hand out of De León.
And he threw it there.
Remember, it was only 52 seconds into his last fight that he had his arm lifted and an unconscious opponent opposite him. There's a right hand from Seager.
Saad Lukman Yantoy of Thailand was knocked out face first, and right now Al Seager has already lasted longer than did Saad.
Saad was planted in the side. There's that big sweeping left hand to the body from Ponce de León.
See, that's when he gets back in more into the amateur stuff there, Joe. Now, his the first left hook,
there and again, Rich.
Yeah, see, the wide lunging punches are like that are probably not going to land on Seager here tonight. But he did land a straight left in the first 30 seconds, which was the same kind of punch that he knocked Saad out with.
Says he hears the criticism from the press and from the boxing insiders as to his style. But he says the fans love his style, so why would he ever want to change that?
I'll tell you one thing about Seager. He's really enjoyed the week here this week. He was smiling the whole week, very polite and courteous to everybody. Even had a smile when he came into the ring, mugging for our cameras a little bit.
And let me add to that by saying that he declared this a business trip. Friends and family from Georgia, if they came, it was on them. He wasn't going to take part in the festivities. This was all about business and creating a better future. Tries with the straight right hand behind the jab. Now you see the movement, and Ponce de León with the wide swinging left and then the right to the body, and they tie up. Left hand of Seager under the right arm of Ponce de León.
By the way, Celestino Caballero, who really handed de León a decisive defeat, is here in the arena to challenge the winner tonight.
Ray Torres will interpret for us for Mario Morales.
too excited.
Dame una botella.
Come on, give me the bottle. Okay.
During the break, watch the kidney punches.
Ya la tengo, ya la tengo.
No quieres.
You don't want any?
Un poquitito más. Un poquito desesperado.
You got to get
desperate
now. Prepare that left hand. He's moving on you. Yeah, he's moving to the same side. He's not doing nothing.
No te va a aguantar porque está muy fuerte. Te está corriendo, no está llaveando.
Right, first round action was interesting from long range. Beautiful right cross by Seager. Got that wide stance of his. But Ponce de Leon, there was the one straight left that he did land. That was the best looking punch, too, that he threw in the round.
The other ones were quite ugly. Wide and sweeping to the waistline. And you heard referee Lawrence Cole warn the corner of Daniel Ponce de Leon to watch the kidney punches. But such is the case with the type of punches he throws matched against the in-and-out style and back-turning of Seager.
I think one of the keys to victory for Seager here tonight, too, Joe, is to make Ponce de Leon pay for it when he throws those wide, long, lunging punches and misses. He's got to put something right on him. When he throws those wild shots, give him a little something to think about afterward.
Seager had to think about shaking off a left hand moments ago. De Leon scored. Now he goes on the attack for a moment. Tries the right hand. De Leon places a straight left, not looping to the body that time. Misses with the right hook and then throws an awkward left hand where he fell forward with that back foot. Seager to the inside. He ties up. He wants no part of Ponce de Leon there.
Jabbing a big key tonight for Seager. If he can land the jab against the southpaw, not always the easiest thing, but to throw him off balance as he comes in. He's moving, he's circling to his left, Seager is, to attempt to get away from the punching power of Daniel Ponce de Leon.
Biggest step-up fight in the career of the 26-year-old Savannah, Georgia native Al Seager. He does have a win over a recent world champion. That's Eric Aiken, and he got up off the canvas to earn that win.
Stop!
And now you can see, as he's bent over and tied up, Ponce de Leon taking a couple extra shots to the body. Comes in hard charging with a left hand. Boy, is he awkward. Wild swinger, and as they separate, Seager places a left hand.
That's making him pay. Ponce de Leon, when they're getting close like that, he needs to throw that left hook to the body. That's his money punch, that left hand.
Getting ugly on the inside. Lawrence Cole, the son of Texas Commissioner Dickie Cole, and a well-experienced referee, is going to take a little bit of control of this fight early on.
Although boxing fans, nice right hand by Seager coming in as De Leon came in at him, were disappointed, of course, by the Juan Manuel Marquez fight falling out tonight. De Leon was just elated to be elevated to the main event.
Pushing over his head, son. You hear me? Slow down and time yourself.
You gotta relax now.
When you twist to the right, slow down, stay there and fucking run your right hook.
You're a big guy. You're a big guy.
You hear me?
Start relaxing now.
Look at me. Come on, man. You put in.
You gotta start putting them together, son.
All right, let's take a look at some of the action. There's that left now. Seager coming forward. And Ponce de Leon, bap, bap, as they were break, they were attempting to be broken by Lawrence Cole, drew a warning there. Of course, Seager initiated that some himself as well by just coming in face forward like that.
Al Seager, nicknamed the Quiet Storm. will need to be heard from offensively at some point. See if he turns it on a little bit here in this third round. Moving on the outside, but circling to his right. He's got to be careful of that left hand of Ponce de Leon. Loaded with power and cranked up and always ready to be fired off.
And Ponce de Leon coming forward now a little bit faster and closing that distance between himself and Seager. And again, on the inside, he's just a handful. He throws that elbow, he throws the shoulder. Even those who feel that De Leon will win here tonight, more ugliness.
You're reaching out and grabbing him, all right? You can't do that, you understand me? All right, that's your first warning.
Even those who felt that De Leon would win here tonight felt that he would face tough moments and at times be made to look bad by Seager, but that eventually he would catch up to him, and then we'd see about Seager's chin.
Seager's finding out that Ponce de Leon has very little to do with boxing. A fight is truly a fight to him.
De Leon says that he's been working on his technique in the gym. They're trying to make him a little bit more polished. But sometimes a fighter's awkwardness and unorthodox nature can work to his advantage.
Although there's that left hand to the body, Rich.
And Ponce de Leon, this is the first time in the fight I feel that his punches are beginning to have some effect.
And if you're saying that with a minute to go in round number three, then good luck to Al Seager as the second half of this fight gets underway. Chops down with the right hand after the left hand.
Al's having a little more difficulty getting away from those punches now. And there is a wide disparity in the punching power between these two. And look at De Leon, he'll just hit you anywhere. He doesn't care really where it is. He's gonna throw punches. If he hits you on the arm, fine. On the elbow, good. On the hip, that's okay.
Marciano wherever. Style, beat your man down. Maybe he won't be raising those arms in a few rounds if you keep hitting there enough. Well placed left hand again. Seager tries head movement, and when that doesn't work, he falls in and ties up. Lunges in, and Seager, that's a slip. But I'll tell you what, he was stunned for a moment. It's just that his feet gave out and tied up with De Leon.
Seager is getting hit some here, and he's feeling it.
Call it a slip all you want. That was a huge round for Daniel Ponce de Leon, the 122-pound belt holder.
Are you all right? Good hand there. Breathe. What's up, this way?
Watch the feet.
All right, here's that sequence. There you see the feet get tangled, and he's actually stepping on Seager's foot at that point. But prior to that, Seager had been rocked just a little, and he ran into that right hand. Look at these angles these punches are coming from. Seager's never seen anything like this style, for sure. Not in Savannah, Georgia.
You got to look good now. You know what he's got? He's got nothing. Now we got to go to a more calm, face him. And then the right hand is going to prepare everything for the right, for the left.
Seeing this style in Savannah, Georgia, you barely see boxing in Savannah, Georgia. Mike Gerald has the only gym in town. And that's where a 10-year-old Al Seager walked into 16 years ago. And now as a 26-year-old, he has found himself with this moment, fighting for a belt and the ability to advance himself. But what a challenge he has in front of him.
Stop.
Yep, here comes Lawrence Cole to clear things up.
122-pound division. Very interesting, though.
Okay,
Lawrence Cole's got his hands full in this one. Very interesting division because you've got this mountain of strength, Israel Vasquez. You've got the pure boxer, Johnny Gonzalez. You've got Rafael Marquez coming up.
How about Rafael Marquez, Israel Vasquez? What a treat that would be.
Oh.
Or what about Daniel Ponce de Leon and his continued growth and his reckless style getting in the mix among those two elites?
And that's where they want to point him. But not yet. Good little sneaky right by Seager.
Seager has not earned De Leon's respect the way he said he would was with his deceptive power. De Leon able to come right in through the front door and do as he pleases.
Daniel doesn't get too discouraged by missing. He's right there with another one.
Oh, that was a solid left hand, and Seager hits the canvas.
Well thrown, technically correct.
Six, seven, eight.
Every once in a while, he mixes in one of those correctly thrown punches, and you see the result.
Straight is great, finds out Ponce. Minute to go, round four. Can Seager survive it? He's been down before and come back to win, but not against this level and not against this power. Another left hand comes crashing home. And he's pushing down on the head as if the left hands aren't enough.
The great equalizer we talked about in our pre-fight comments. This kid can crack.
And as he noted, why change the style when the fans love it? They are on their feet here in El Paso.
He's roughing Seager up now, too. Kind of just mauling him on the rope, brutalizing him.
Ponce de Leon.
First knockdown of the fight, recorded by Ponce de Leon with that straight left hand, a thing of beauty. But it followed the right jab. They told him in his corner that if he jabbed with the right, that the power would follow, and they weren't lying. And that's good to see from the standpoint of a kid setting things up for Joe, because he set up the left cross with a perfect right jab.
26-year-old titleist told us that he thinks he's been improving, that you'll see it in the way he executes his combinations. We believe it in the fourth round. He's trying to cut down the ring now and find the elusive Al Seager.
And something that Seager really needs is to get some respect from De Leon. He might get it with more of those straight rights. He's got a good quick right. It's a short right hand. It's sneaky. He can throw it straight, or he throws a little twisting uppercut. But he's not putting that on Ponce de Leon. So De Leon has just walked. There it is. There's that right hand. See, that will stop De Leon in his tracks.
On cue, Rich. And that's really needed by Seager. You got to try to slow down the raging bull. Another well-placed left hand, and now Seager is absorbing. There's that short right hand. Timed it, countered against the left hand of Ponce. Ponce back to the jab and keeps coming forward, and a strong short right hand staggers Seager.
That's not the punch that Seager's expecting. See that?
Never.
The one you don't expect, the one you're not looking for, can often be the trouble spot.
So worried about the left hands, he forgot about the right hook from the devastating punching southpaw. Boy, that would serve him well if he went back to it. There's the straight left. Final minute of this fifth round.
Right.
De Leon is a wild swinger, boy. He is a free swinger.
Fun to watch.
Oh, he doesn't want to be in this corner. Seager better escape from there real quick.
Break! I don't know at this point where Seager wants to be.
Perhaps Savannah, Georgia?
Perhaps. Watching the boats go down the river. Look at that.
What was that?
If you're Lawrence Cole. Well, I'm actually surprised there's no point deduction there. Cole's a good referee, an experienced guy. Wants to try to keep this thing fresh, safe, clean. But that was quite obvious. That was a tie up and a break, and then a tomahawk chop from Ponce de Leon.
It was like bringing the hammer down.
True fight.
Yeah, you're not going to have a polite fight. As you can see, there's a variety of blows that kind of bend the rules. We're just
it's got a little bit of everything. The rabbit punches, the kidney shots. There's one right there.
It's all part of the arsenal. Wild punches that become just dirty fighting, but it's all part of the arsenal.
Here's one of my favorites.
Yeah, the hammer.
Round six, heading towards the halfway point of this 122-pound bout. Joe Tessitore and Rich Marotta with you.
Break! No punching, no punching, stop!
Problem for Seager is De Leon has not slowed down a bit.
Seager has only shown two or three glimpses of the short right hand that he boasted of, and that has been successful when he's committed to it. But it's tough to make that decision when you know what's coming back in return, Rich.
Yeah, and sometimes you don't know. You're hesitant because you don't know what's coming. You know, especially with this guy. He bends to throw a left hand and he throws the right from the other side. I mean, it really is very, very difficult to prepare for this.
That was one of those wide swinging left hands that caught Seager. Seager was bent over, not where he wants to be.
We mentioned some of those other champions, you know, like Israel Vasquez and Rafael Marquez, going from 118 to 120. They're far more polished than Daniel Ponce de Leon at this point. And I don't think that Daniel could hang with those guys right now. That's not
well,
to say that he can't.
I think they'd counter him all night long. But I think there's going to be a point, don't you, Rich, where in the near future, fans will be very excited to see him against those elite 118, moving up to 122s. And onward,
sure,
to the featherweights.
Because he is actually, believe it or not, more polished now than he was a few fights ago.
Scary thought.
And he's going to get better. They are trying to develop some technique. But you don't want to tone it down too much, because some of that craziness that he gives you helps him.
Fans don't. TV networks don't. There's that short right hand from Seager. Ponce de Leon not only unaffected, but on the attack.
He walked right through it. De Leon just looks like he's ignoring the Seager power shot.
Picking his spots now with ease. And Seager becoming a much more manageable target. Six, Ponce de Leon in control.